Hello. Welcome to the Online Strength Coach Podcast. Episode 63. New Year's Resolutions. Hello. Happy New Year to all the Online Strength Coach Podcast listeners. All three of you. Wonder if that joke's ever going to run out or become stale. I imagine it may have already. Welcome to 2016. Today I'm recording this podcast on the 6th of January, Wednesday, 2016. And I thought a good topic for the start of the new year would be New Year's resolutions. First of all, I think I'll start off by explaining my New Year's resolutions, and then I have just a bit of a general discourse on goal setting through the year, specific to strength training or powerlifting. So I've decided I would not have really set New Year's resolutions. Thought it was a bit of a fad, a bit of a gimmick. Didn't really see the utility of it from my point of view. However, kind of more towards later years, like 2012, 2013, I started viewing it becoming more deliberately goal oriented, setting deliberate goals, trying to set deliberate time frames to achieve certain things within professional life and within lifting and whatnot. It is one of the most important things in life is to have a clear vision of where you're going and have a clear timeline of how you're going to get there, or have a clear timeline of how long it's going to take you to get there, and have a clear roadmap of how it's going to happen. And the roadmap is the small cumulative goals that are going to reach the pinnacle or the end goal. So this year I've decided to go for two New Year's resolutions that are quite simple, but I think they'll help me a lot in the long run. They're not goal based this year. For example, in 2013 I moved out of full-time employment I had a fairly comfortable job, but it was a bit of a dead-end job. It was well paid, but it wasn't in the avenue that I wanted to be in. It was close. It was within the gym environment. I was working with lifters on a regular basis. I was making a pretty reasonable living, but it wasn't that intellectually stimulating at times. It was a lot of downtime. It wasn't creative enough. It was round about what I wanted to do, but it wasn't exactly what I wanted to do. So I was basically pushed into a corner that year where I could pursue part-time employment and strength addition working with athletes, or I could continue on with my full-time employment, earning a decent living, working with lifters, but with a lot of downtime and something that wasn't so challenging, or something that I did not find challenging, didn't find engaging. So after a lot of deliberation over the Christmas period, I decided to go for it. Jacked in the full-time job, took on part-time employment, or pursued the part-time employment. I was already employed part-time, and used that, the 6 months it ended up being, to develop other things, like started to develop this channel, started to take the blog more seriously, got the blog's own website, and started to develop down that line. Kind of the side projects that I'm currently still maintaining, but trying to develop and move forward, which I want to achieve a lot more of in this year. So that's an example of and the goal that year was to end the year earning more money, doing what I wanted to do, than when I finished in 2013. At the end of 2013, I achieved that goal. So it wasn't, it ended up being a bit fortuitous. I ended up falling into a role in rugby, on a part-time, 0 hours contract basis. Got stuck into that, threw myself into it, and at the end of the preseason, got offered a full-time contract, and now I'm doing pretty much exactly what I wanted to do when I set out for my degree in 2007, so nearly 10 years ago. God damn, time passes quickly. So yeah, this year, my two goals, one's to wake up at 5 a.m. every morning, apart from Sunday, and that's to give me the time to actually work towards side projects and things. It's give me time to work with emails, to develop ideas, to create articles, to work with the website, to start developing other websites, and start pushing more towards those goals that I think are where ultimately I want to go, really. Is down that kind of self-employed route. Operate my own business, operate several businesses, not be tied down to one employer, have complete say over my own time. These are the things that are kind of driving factors for me at the minute that I want to develop. So having that extra time, I'm in no rush to leave my current employment. I've got some goals and things I want to achieve within my current realm of employment. So I can see myself being full-time employed for another 5, possibly 10 years. But I want to set up, to get things rolling, so it's an easy transition eventually for me to become self-employed and do my own thing. I don't know what time frame that's going to happen over, but I want to begin the process this year in earnest. I've already began the process, but I want to push forward with it. And then the second one is to try a challenge every month, or to engage in a challenge or to do something every month that pushes me out of my comfort zone. So the first month I do January. So if you're not from the UK, it's a charity thing. I've done this 2 years ago, where I set up the page and got the sponsors and all the whole nine yards. This year, I'm just doing it. I haven't set up the sponsorship page. I've not done any of that stuff. I'm just doing it for myself. So I'm doing the whole month of January without alcohol. And if anyone knows me, they'll know from me that is a reasonable commitment. And I'm a pretty big beer fan. I do enjoy a drink 2 or 3 nights a week, minimum. Probably 2, 3 to 4, probably a bit more like it. I do like a beer. So it is quite a large challenge for me, but I think something that's extremely positive and something that I would actually quite like to carry on maybe for the year. And we'll see how I go in the first month. There are some instances I don't want to be totally hamstrung. I want to enjoy myself, but productivity wise I can see this being like a massive boon. So those, next month I've put my challenge for next month in the hands of somebody else, and that's something I might do to develop that resolution throughout the year, is give someone the task of choosing me a challenge, a non-exercise related challenge, because I think my exercise is quite well honed and I'm happy with what I'm doing there. So this is probably a good opportunity to segue into setting strength goals, because I do have some goals this year, obviously as regards strength training and powerlifting. So this year I want to get back to the platform. So there's a competition on the 7th of February that I'd like to attend for. I'd like to register for and attend, but I've not done yet and need to do that. So yeah, for that competition I want to set a minimum of 750 kilo total, although I'd like to set a 770 total. I'd like to squat 280, bench 200, and deadlift 292, and do that with at least 10 kilos left in each lift. So I want all of my attempts on the platform to be sub-maximal. I want it to be a nice easy day out, bit of fun, bit of crack, and handle all the lifts easy on the platform. Like a sub-maximal max day is the way I want to treat it. Then I want to set quite a large PB doing that. I want to compete in the 120s this year, or at least for a portion of this year. And I want to achieve some milestone lifts. Milestone lifts I want to achieve. I want to achieve 300 kilo squat. I would like to achieve that within the first 6 months of this year. Or I can certainly get within touching distance if I don't actually do the lift. I want to achieve a 300 kilo deadlift, which I definitely want to achieve. I want, as part of this thing, is the 292 deadlift. That would be a personal best. So that personal best on the platform is big. So I don't think I've ever set a deadlift PB on the platform. Maybe I might have done the first couple of years of competing, but I certainly haven't done it in the last 5-6 years. All of my deadlift PBs have been done in the gym, so I'd actually like to, that's one of the mental things I think to get over for me this year is the, I think my deadlift training has improved quite a lot. I've deadlifted 260 for 3 without a belt, which was a triple PB. I've done 280 without a belt, which was a 10 kilo deadlift PB. I put 20 kilos on my beltless deadlift this year, but also I'm a lot heavier, so I don't know how that's going to relate when I put the belt back on a deadlift, because I don't really feel that the belt helped a lot when in deadlift. And bench press, I want to keep my shoulders injury free, which I've pretty much maintained for the best part of a year now. And I want to get that 220 kilo bench done. So this year I want to bench 210, sort of 200 to 210 in competition. But 200 kilos would be a great first step towards that. So for listeners doing this thing, when you set your own goals when it comes to lifting, I think it's good to be clear, have in your head exactly what you want to do. It's good to have time frames on it, so it's no use saying you want to squat 300 kilos if you're squatting 220 kilos, it's too far away. Maybe that's something that's an aspiration, something you want to do in 2 or 3 years, but this year, maybe you want to squat 220 beltless, which is going to bring that up, going to bring your squat level up so that you're coming closer to your goal, or maybe you want to squat 240 for two. Smaller goals that are achievable, that are going to lead towards your end goal. Maybe you find front squats a good indicator of where you want to be. So maybe you, as part of front back squatting 300, maybe you need to get your back squat up to 220. You know, there's a whole load of ways of doing it. But yeah, I think having these goals crystal clear in your head and having time frames on them and having smaller goals on the way is how you're going to achieve them. So if you'd like to leave some comments down below, maybe let me know what your goals are for the year, whether lifting or life-based. Hope you've enjoyed listening to the podcast. Again, Happy New Year. I'll be coming back with another podcast this week, so if you want to hit me up with a topic, that'd be sweet. Alright, hope you enjoyed listening. This is the Online Strength Coach Podcast. It's Mark signing out. Happy 2016. You gotta mask. I got a plan to get us out of here. Been working at the convenience store. Managed to save just a little bit of money. Won't have to drive too far. Just cross the border and into the city. You and I can both get jobs. Finally see what it means to be living.